Sunday Best. I like that song. Now that spring has sprung, it's time to gear up and start spring cleaning. Katie Brown joins us now with some cleaning and organizing tips to kickstart spring cleaning.
That's
welcome
right.
back.
Thank you. Thank you.
Great
Thank
to have
you
your energy in studio.
Me. It is, this is, I love this. I love spring cleaning. I love getting into all the nooks and crannies that get ignored all year
it's my
round.
My favorite time to clean.
And I got some good tips for you. First okay. of all, this is great for getting your kids, your husband, all the people who don't like to spring clean as much as me. I have a caddy for each room, and they can go under their bed, they can go in the bathroom under the sink, so they always have everything they need right there, and there is no excuse.
No excuse.
Don't fill it up too full. Make it nice and light so that they, you
and
know.
You can put their name right on there, too,
you? Can put their
you?
Name right on there, and they're good right. to go. Now, when it comes to cleaning in your kitchen, there's some great things that you can do so that you don't have to use any products that might be kind of harmful to your food. Just go to your refrigerator, get a lemon, get a potato, get an onion, some salt, some baking soda, some cream of tartar, and I'm going to tell you what to do. Sometimes when you have a cast iron pan and it gets rust in the corner, or you know, it sits too long and you sure. want to give it a good cleaning, all you have to do is take a potato and some baking soda, a little bit of water, scrub it out, and you'll see you'll rinse it right out in that potato.
Wait, so this cleans it?
Yeah, the starch from that makes the baking soda get to be a nice paste with a little bit of water, and that gets it right out of there.
Wow.
Okay?
And do you use it afterwards, or do they throw it out?
I don't think baking soda and potato would be so right. good. Next Pass. Up, your grill. Your grill needs a little bit of loving. Summer's coming up. You're going to want to cook a lot on it, so all you got to do is take an onion, cut it in half, stab it with a fork, get the grill really nice and hot, put the onion all over your grill, and it'll make kind of a steam bath, oniony steam bath that gets right in there and makes
I didn't see it, but I'm guessing Kelly has a grimace on her face.
Yeah, right she might. She might right now.
I didn't
now.
See it, but...
All your stainless steel appliances. A great thing to do is get a little bit of cream of tartar, mix it with a little bit of water. It makes a great paste. Shine it all, you know, put it all over it, and it gives it a shine, rinse it at the end, and it gives it a great shine.
This smells like me after PE.
Next up is vinegar and water. When I use this a lot when I'm cleaning my sink, when I'm cleaning spots on my countertop, equal parts water, equal parts vinegar. Spray away, clean away. If you don't like the vinegar smell, although it does go away pretty quickly, just do a little bit of soap and water at the end, and you're set and ready to go.
Okay.
Now, next up, people do not clean their brooms.
These people are upsetting
me. You promise me. Is it upsetting?
I'm very upsetting. There's so many things living.
It's so many awful things. Just like you clean out a mop, put a little soap and water in a bucket, put your broom in there, shake it around, move it around, let it dry. You got a brand new broom. Mm-hmm. I mean, come on. Okay, now the bathroom.
This always freaks me out.
Okay, I'm going to help you not freak out. Take your regular household cleaner that has a little bit of scent in it, pour it into the bottom, just a little bit, enough, like I would say about an inch, inch and a half, into the bottom, so that when you pull it out, it's always going to be a little bit clean, it's always going to smell good, and it won't freak you out.
Mine always says toilet paper still stuck to it.
Oh, no, that's disgusting. Yeah, that's gross. That's an overshare.
Where's the tip on that?
That's an overshare.
Where's the tip on that? All right, Katie, listen, on that note, we take a break, we catch our breaths, we come back. Kelly is coming in for her tips.
He's like, after this. Toilet paper.
More tips after this. Hang on.
We are back with Katie Brown, and we are spring cleaning, and nobody knows how to spring clean like this lady right here. Katie, you're the only person I know, besides me, that gets this excited about cleansing
things. I love spring cleaning. Yep. It's that time of year where you get all the stuff that you never really get. And this segment, because another thing you do while you're spring cleaning is think about how you're going to organize, right? You're finally cleaning out that closet.
Yes.
How can you organize it better? One great thing to do is all your camisoles. Get some shower curtain rings, put it on a hanger, hang your camisoles. Great, right?
That's so funny. You know what I do? I hang all of my camisoles on the same hanger on top of each other.
Yeah, don't have to do that anymore. They're not going to get all tangled. You could also do this with your pants and put your belt buckle through there. You know, your little buckle thing. Yeah. Do that.
Okay. Interesting.
All your cans that you drink your sodas out of, break off that cap right there, and instead of buying like expensive hangers that have one too many, you can customize your own by taking those tops, popping them over the hanger, and hanging them down, putting all your t-shirts
Very
and stuff
smart.
Like that.
Very smart, yep.
Don't throw away your chip cylinders. Take that and all those garbage bags that are under your sink that are so disorganized. Pop them in there. You can take this on your dog walk. You know, it's a good
I'm going to do this for my mom.
Yeah, right?
Because it's... it's insurmountable, the amount of plastic bags that are there.
Yes, and they come and they seem to grow. I think
they
hatch.
They do, they multiply.
I think they hatch under
They're
the
gremlins of the supermarket world.
This is a spring cleaning fan's best friend. It's your lint roller. You can use it for so many things besides your thing. When it comes to doing this, don't forget your lampshades. Just take that lint roller that you usually use for your clothes and lint off and get all the dust and all the muck off of your lampshade, right?
Isn't that fun? In a chimney?
I know, I know. Now, I make all my kids take all the cushions off all of my couches, and I get that vacuum cleaner right in between the crevices. You can also do this on your windowsill where those little lines are that you can't get in there. Take either a toilet paper roll or a paper towel roll. You can fit it to whatever size you need, and it's a great homemade adapter that can get into all those small nooks and crannies, right?
Don't you love when you hear something get sucked in there and you're like, that's not right.
Got it. Now, the other thing is pet hair, which is every pet owner's worst nightmare. You know the squeegee that you use for your shower?
Yep.
Get it a little bit wet, rake it over the rugs, rake it over your furniture, and that pet hair is gonna come off.
Is that true?
It's totally true. Ugh. Same thing, guys, same kind of system when it comes to your gloves, your rubber gloves, a little bit of water, rub it over wherever your pet hair is, it'll come right off, go rinse it under the sink, you're good to go. All right, we have to go.
Oh my gosh, there's so many more tips. Okay, listen.
Yeah.
Make sure you check out Katie's book, Dare to See.
Thank you.
And Katie has more tips on our website, so make sure you go to our website to check out all of these great tips. Katie, thank you so much. Congratulations on your daughter.
Oh, thank you.
So happy for you. Always great to see you. And our good news story of the day when we return.